Sifu Klaus Brandt, International Academy of Wing Chun, Fundamentals, and today, again, Basics, Man and Wu, but now with together with Zong Kun Thrusting Punch, or just Punch. We want to define what is the preparation of Man and Wu, why are these positions as high, and what is the real preparation? Do we, or are we ready to defend, or are we ready to attack? We can do some partner training with it to understand the position much better and easier. To let's say we speak about the main distance. If I have a partner, for example, and we spoke in the last training, or in the last video about Man and Wu, just about the position, what it is, but now we can define it a bit better together with the main distance. The main distance is very, very important, because outside main distance I cannot reach my partner, he cannot reach me, so we don't have actually to, or the necessity to prepare something, but we could. So if I know that I have to prepare myself because I see someone wants to attack me, so I have the chance, in if you are outside main distance, to prepare with Man and Wu. And this is as a preparation, in the same time as security. I see a lot of pictures if hands are very, very low. Man and Wu is hanging like this, or like this. So it's looking cool, but not functional anymore. That the problem was that the people left the functionality, and so they created a coolness, a style of coolness. But coolness is no substitute for functionality. So we have to stay functional, and functional is protection. The main attacks are coming high to your head, neck, chest, or whatever. But even high if they are coming outside to your head, to your neck, same thing. So we have to defend something which is coming straight and high, or round, left and right, outside, high or low, straight or in infight, even from the side, but from the distance first, straight. So we have four possibilities to have to prepare, or to be prepared for. This is straight, low, outside, left and right. And if your hands are just here, of course it's a good security against low attacks, but it's not a preparation and a security in one time. At one time it's a bit problematic, because you have to lift up first to go forward. And what we do in, or to prepare Man and Wu, is we lift up primary. The position of Man and Wu is already security. So try to avoid this cool style. Do it like we are doing it in our form, and prepare to be protected first before you do a punch, or before you are doing or preparing a defense. If he is just coming into my main distance, and so in your training you have to train a lot of timing, because some are slow, some are fast, and so it's all about timing, your timing to react, to prepare. But all what I can prepare, if I see this attack very late, or I just wait too long, or something else, so I am late, I have to react. It looks like this. That means I prepare my Wu, I prepare my fist, my strike, I strike. Wu, preparation, and action. Zong Kü, that is a Zong Kü. The wrist is as high as your shoulder to really work from the source of your arm to the tip of your arm, your fist, to the function. And no lifting, nothing else, and security from the first, very first moment. If he is far away, so the first what I did is I prepared to punch or to be protected. I did not know it, but he did not strike me, so I could strike first. If I see that he prepares something, of course, and we are outside main distance, I can prepare a new Wu position, which is left now. That means my strike is definitely left now. The first wanted to be right, but the second one is definitely left. I prepare Marlin Wu, he comes closer, I strike. Now I stroke left. Very, very important for you to know that you first, your primary, want to attack with your right hand. If this is not possible because the attacker comes later, he prepares, he's outside main distance, you prepare a new Wu. And now your new plan is to strike with Wu, which is the left hand. After the left hand strike, you prepare a strike with your right hand again, and so it changes all the time. Very important here is that as soon as you finish your strike and you prepare a new one, you go down with your elbow to free the way for the next strike. It looks like this. You lift it, and this movement we call Wu. This is nothing, it's just to be free with your Wu to strike. This is Wu, and this is looks like an eccentric movement. It's straight, it falls down, it comes up. It's not really eccentric, it's just a function which is just down with your elbow to free the way for the next strike and lifting to prepare Wu. And this is something you have to learn and to work on it to make it pretty quickly. The Marlin Wu is always a new preparation, but very important to know for you is that the strike from the Zhong Kun, or with from Wu position actually, with Zhong Kun, is only a strike for the beginning of every fight. During a fight, or for the most attacks, we have to defend, and after the most defenses, we cannot strike from Zhong Kun. We cannot strike from Zhong Kun anymore. If someone attacks me from outside and I prepare like this, a Tan, and I can strike from Zhong Kun, that's no question. I can use my Zhong Kun to defend it, or I prepare Tan and Wu in one position and strike from Wu, of course, to prepare against to work against outside strikes. That's okay. But in the most situations for straight attacks, or during our lasso program, or during our chi sao sections, we do not have, we cannot use a Zhong Kun anymore. There's a reason we have that many different Kun versions, 13 Kun versions in three forms. It's a lot, and it's not the only possibility to attack the other one as well. So it's enough selection, and it's enough to decide for another version like Zhong Kun, Go Ping Kun, Quan Kun, Jun Kun. We have a lot of Kuns and versions from other positions to strike with our fist. No problem. So see you soon. Sifu Klaus Bentley.